Hello, y'all. Welcome to a River Dog production. Enjoy the picturesque scenery I have included for your entertainment value. No dark screen, like some people do. And they chat and get up and do a smoke break and leave you in the blank dark world of cyberspace. I will include my photography. Anyway, yeah, I've been traveling the last few days, and I don't know what day this is. Wednesday? Monday? Tuesday? I don't know. I lose track of time as I get older. It's like harder and harder to keep track. What I find anymore is that traveling in itself is exhausting. I mean, the stuff I've seen these last few days is amazing. It really is. And I've seen a lot of California already. I've seen a lot of the world. I've seen a lot of the country. I mean, 12 years in the service and a couple of branches of the service and having been overseas and done a couple of West Packs and stationed in Germany. And I saw quite a bit of the world. And then I drove long haul for a couple of years anyway. I think it was like 2 years. Saw most of the states and even through the military, I saw a lot of the United States too. And I always used to travel when I started staying local as far as driving. I still traveled quite a bit within California, you know, for the most part. You know, I'd quit going out of state too much except for going to Vegas and Arizona a couple of years. But yeah, I find this doing it the van lifestyle, even though it's way better, obviously, than the tent would be, it's still kind of a chore. To be honest, until you get your systems dialed in the way you want, you're trying to figure out how to store everything out, where to put it for easy access, all that type of stuff. And I find really in reality, I don't need half of what I brought. I kind of wish I had downsized a little bit in what I did bring. And organization is the key. I find it kind of exhausting trying to set everything up to cook or anything else. I just started eating my food cold. I'm like, I prefer this. I'm going to eat everything cold. So if you can do solar, I recommend it. If you can put a solar panel on top of the roof. But the problem with that, I find, if you got inclement weather or it's cloudy, you're going to have a problem soaking up the rays. I mean, the thing is, while you're driving, you could probably soak up some pretty good rays to charge your house battery. But when you're boondocking for extended periods of time, you got to be in direct sunlight with the damn thing. And who really wants to sit in direct sunlight, you know, if you can prevent it, you know? I mean, even in the desert, sometimes you can find shade. I mean, that's what I do. I position a vehicle to find shade wherever I can find it. Like out here in where I'm at now in Anza Borrego, there's actually shade, big bushy trees. So I figured, well, sorry about the messages, by the way. It's an ex-flame of mine, I think, trying to reach out to me. She's begging me back. It's really sad when women are desperate for a fat old man like me. That's a case with the Philippines right now. It's desperate times. You know, desperate times call for desperate measures. You got to find whatever you can find, wherever you can get it. And in the case of the Philippines, it's with me. You know, with some Filipino women. I mean, with a guy like me. Can you imagine that? Look at my toothless smile. I'm old, grizzled, broken down old man. Over the hill, has been. You know, truck driver. I mean, I'm a catch, ain't I? Jesus. Go figure, right? But anyway, getting back to van life, man. I guess I like it. You become more active, definitely. But I've been just exhausted these last few days. I'm like, Jesus, am I so far gone already at age 57 that I'm starting to lose joy in the things that I used to really revel in? I mean, I'm not losing joy, don't get me wrong. I'm just don't have the same energy level I used to have. That's my fault. I've been too holed up too long because of the goddamn COVID-19. Even though I have traveled, I've done a lot of trips this last year. But I think travel in itself just wears a person down over time. Almost feel like really glamping it. And I don't mean RV even. I mean like luxury motel with a hot tub right now would be fantastic, man. Or in a good freaking massage. That's what I need right now. Anyway, I kind of enjoyed this trip. I decided purposely on seeing things I'd never seen before, like in these photos of Slab City. Some of the places I've been, I definitely wouldn't recommend going to. Maybe once, but don't stay the night. Like, for example, what you're looking at now, Slab City. But if you've never seen Salvation Mountain, you've got to see it at least once. Or even Slab City. It's like one of the last free places where you could live and squat and express yourself completely freely without any kind of recrimination for the most part, outside of the fact you might get attacked middle of the night. It was interesting. Would I do it again? No. Once done, that's all you need to do one time. I survived it for 2 days. That was enough. So my thoughts now with the whole van life thing, I love California, but I think in the future, I'm going to glamp it, man. I'm going to get motels every now and then or something, you know, just to break the monotony of traveling and living in a van. But the Philippines, definitely, I'm targeting the Philippines in the future. Anyway, guys, thank you for tuning in. Take care. Bye.